guys, and welcome to my brand new Patreon server. I finally did it. I bit the bullet and I was like, you know, I've got people showing their respect for me and their support. I would like to do something to give back to them. So I made a plains biome. No, I made an entire server here for us to all come along and play on. No one is here at the moment because I have started this at a very, very funny time, really, for everyone in the world, so I can understand why they're not here. And I thought I would show you this pristine space before... Look at all the mess. Oh, look, there's a new building over there. That's cool. So this jump cut was supposed to go a little bit different to what just happened there, but unfortunately McKerbal Collaborative Warfare save landed in my lap, and then a week and a half kind of just disappeared, as it does when Collaborative Warfare turns up. And then I come back to the Patreon server to see what everyone's been doing, and people have been busy, it turns out. Good old farm going here. Like, me and Mr. Lion started this up when we first started. Well, I've had a little bit of running around time and talking to a few people. Me and ZTech started on that. Neither of us, I think, are really happy in the direction it's going, but we will work on it. We will get it better. ZTech, I think, is working on his base over there. And my jump cut was supposed to come into me going, oh, look, here's an area I'm going to build a base in, but I've not had time to do that. So let's go and have a look around and see what sort of place we can pick for ourselves, shall we? I'm definitely thinking up this sort of hill direction from spawn is the way I want to go. I might leave this little hill space here for the farm building that we seem to be having on the go. I think a small sort of industrial farm complex might not go amiss on the side of spawn. I'm kind of feeling this sort of area here. I mean, it's the ground's a little bit holy, but we can definitely deal with that. And it gives me a good space to kind of stretch out and build some stuff. There's a pillar over there. I wonder what that is all about. I've got an idea for my residence that I wish to build. It's not going to be quite on the scale of ZTech's HQ over there. That is coming on beautiful. I think he was having trouble getting all the glass together. Need to go off on a big exploration and find some desert somewhere. But yeah, I think what we need to do is take a path coming off of spawn. This spawn platform, this is not a finished article. We just kind of wanted to put down somewhere to mark off the area that was the actual spawn platform. I think the same with the nether portal here. I should imagine someone needed to just go and grab something, so they put this here. We'll find somewhere better for it. But yeah, let me throw down some markings, maybe a bit of a floor plan, and I'll be right back. Do you like my dirt house? I think it's kind of nice, but I think I've got the proportions all wrong here. I think this bottom bit needs to come down one. Oh no, I can't reach it. Oh, will you look at that? Yeah, I think this needs to come down one, and then maybe that stays where it is up there, and then it'll be two floors for the vast bulk of this room. I don't know, we'll put something nice out here, coming out of here. But look at the things going on around me. Oh my, will you look at this? So Mr. Lion came on last night. So there's been a real-time sleep in between then and now. Mrs. Lion came on last night, and me and her sat down and thought about how we're going to do a spawn area here. You'll see that nasty spawn platform's gone. You kind of spawn in this area here. Here's the spawn block of the world. That's where it all starts. I put that down when we started. It's good. It's coming along nicely. Obviously, just like bare bones and frames at the moment, but I am super impressed with what's going on here. So my house... So I want to do it in like some ultra fresh modern style. The problem with that is that obviously we've not found a mesa. We don't know where any clay is. This is my entire resource. I went out mining. I found some diamonds. Yay. But yeah, I've not really done too much. We cleared out a little bit of space here. I will be back when I've thought about what this actual space is going to look like, what we're actually going to build it out of. I've got a feeling maybe... spruce wood or something. I don't know. I would like to do clays and stuff for a sort of a more modern style, sort of a juxtaposition against that thing, but I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to do that. For those of you that hate the birch log texture out there, don't hate me. I think this is kind of the cleanest look we can get given the materials that we've got at the moment. I'm not sure about these windows. I'm going to fill them with black glass pane. Yes, I had to emphasise that with a shake of the camera there. I'm thinking about black glass pane. But the thing that's stopping me just filling this with glass at the moment is wondering whether we need... like a side thing here, a way to separate the window from this support beam here. Now I'm thinking either it'll be birch planks. Do we have any birch planks? Now, and this is the thing that's holding me up, is waiting for these trees to grow. In the meantime, I have done some other things, some server admin stuff, if you will. You'll see there's all this stuff here. Let me show you a little secret here. If we run all the way through... Now, there was a creeper in here somewhere. I don't really want to incur his wrath anywhere. Okay. We'll come stand on the center of the world. We go, like, TP me. We want to go down 65 blocks. Whoa. I put a command block thing in place. Now, this is going to be a relatively regular thing on here, because I like command blocks. Command blocks are definitely where my passion lies here. This is literally just a sleep thing. This one here adds... I can't get into it because I'm not in creative mode. This one here adds one to a count for sleeping, and then at various stages during that count, different things happen. Like this one, if you just get out of the bed, it will detect that you're not in bed and reset your score again. This one will clear the bad weather if you're in bed beyond a certain amount of time. The amount of time is how long it will take this one to get to morning if you've gone to bed at night, at dusk. Once we've gone past that time, this one will then go, oh, it must be bad weather, clear that. And this one just tells people that that's happened. Okay, cool. Now, I actually came down on top of this block, didn't I? So let's try and do this like this. Perfect. Yeah, look at that. That was going to kill me. We'll have to move that or something. But yeah, I will get back... Oh, wrong direction. I will get back to you guys when I've put some glass in the windows and maybe filled out the frame completely. I just wanted to really show you that I had done the little sleep timer thing, because we were having troubles with that the other day.
It's so pretty.
So I had myself a little bit of a wander around, and I managed to go and find some dark oak trees, that which was lovely. I also got myself a few little puppies in there, all three of them. I did have four. Unfortunately, late at night, a skeleton came along and kind of killed one of them. I've also been corralling up some flowers here, because they've just been going all over the place and getting in all sorts of trouble. But we're supposed to be talking about this. I kind of like what I have done here. The uprights being the same as the top there really didn't do it for me. And I'm not sure about this. I'm not sure. But I think all in all, it's looking quite nice. The entranceway is definitely taking on a snap of pizzazz. I am thinking of replacing this with a lamp and putting a little quartz daylight sensor on top of it. Speaking of quartz, we were having a little bit of trouble with the nether for some reason. Look! It's a wild player. See, it's not just me like doing stuff on my own. There are other people here. The nether, we had a bit of trouble with that. It turns out that, you know, someone who was supposed to be in charge of this sort of stuff didn't check the server properties and make sure the nether was running. But yeah, this is looking all good here. The back wall will need to change immensely. I just kind of put in a rough stairway here. I don't like it. I don't like it at all. Not just the fact that... Oh, look, he's using it. He's using it. Let's watch that. There we go. See, the things I build do work. Honest. It's not central. I don't like the fact that I have to use a stair at the bottom here and a stair at the top to make it work properly. I mean, I suppose I don't really. I also don't like the fact that once this wall's in place, we're going to have a single line to get through here. So I don't know. We'll have to figure that out. Perhaps move it over a little bit. But I just wanted you guys to know that I got puppies and cat and flowers, and that, you know, other people come on the server with me occasionally. Yeah. It's been a little bit of time since my last cut, and I'm truly sorry about that. I've been doing all sorts of things with the new hardware I've got hold of. It was my birthday a few weeks ago, and so I've had a little bit of money to spend on stuff, and I've got a brand new PC. Well, pretty much, anyway. This has meant there has been a lot of time between the jump cuts, and I've got on and done a whole lot of stuff. Now, I think this is absolutely stunning. I really cannot get over how well I have done here. This may look a bit bare bones. That's because it's going to eventually become a small little spot for my dog here. Well, my dogs... Oh, wait, we couldn't do that without standing them up. Who, unfortunately, keep wanting to try and get involved in any battle that I'm having outside. Now, obviously, like, at night, there'll be, like, a skeleton stood here or something, because I haven't lit anywhere up, because, you know, I'm super good like that. And then I'll come out and start a fight, and then these guys keep, like, trying to pour through the door. This fence business, by the way... It's generally all right. It's generally all right. Like, most things will get caught up on the corner here whilst you dip nip through the middle. As you can see, the dogs always get stuck on there. They won't get through there. I have had the odd zombie wander in, but that's nothing too much to worry about. I've started furnishing the area. I think this is kind of looking nice. This is sort of the style I'm going for. The whole lime and purple thing is kind of my thing. If we like just have a look, lime and purple, pretty big on my skin here. I'm not sure about these little tabley desk things here. I don't know what, I mean, what are these? Like, really, what are these? I might put some bookshelves across here or something like this, and this like super annoys me. Oh, I got food. Wow, there's stuff in here and things. Okay, that's pretty cool. The other major thing that I've been working on, as well as upstairs, like, let's go and have a quick look upstairs. This is the area I've been kind of struggling the most with furniture. Like, love this. Love this to bits. The whole trapdoor's being able to float on the side of stuff. I'm thinking I'm going to put some stuff here, maybe make this a little corner chair or something like that. This sucks. Just absolutely sucks. Going to have to do something about that. But we've also been working downstairs. Now, I've got a little prisoner here. Oh, what was that? A little bit of a lag spike there. We've got a little prisoner here. We're just using him, obviously, to make some snow. We've not been making lots of chests because at the moment this is all the space I need. Most of my valuables are upstairs, but everything else is kind of down here. Well, that is going to be super loud on my microphone, isn't it? Redstone's doing well. But talking of redstone, have you seen my little secret chamber? If we just kind of move side to side, you can see there's a little thing here. Hello. What are you doing down here? You shouldn't be down here. But anyway, here's a little anteroom, specifically done in granite to kind of blend in with a little bit of dirt up the top and stuff like that. But if we come all the way to the back here and press this little hole, we get dropped down perfectly into this little blob of water so we can travel down to my mining area. And I bring you to my lapis testing well just to show you quickly the evolution of that particular drop mechanism here. So it started off with all sorts of silent systems here. I've just been watching some of Morzy and I was like, hey, I really like the little system he did here. I believe it was for his Y-shift elevator. Unfortunately, the thing that I made here totally did it in the wrong timing. So I then had to work on some other stuff around here, but this was getting super bulky by the time we got this. I mean, look at all this round here. We come out four blocks and did stuff like this. So working up here, hang about, I've got a box here. Working up here, I eventually managed to streamline it down. Now, this is a silent version, as small as it possibly could get, but I ended up making this version in the end. This one is basically all around the piston bud, piston monostable pulse maker. And then from there, it's all just timings to make sure that the dispenser fires twice and that you get dropped just after the water gets pressed. I know we could have just put water at the bottom and dropped us, but like the whole timing challenge was really what it was all about. And then we're down in my little mining area just to show you what I've been doing. Nothing too major. This is mainly trying to look for slime chunks, if I'm to be brutally honest, because, you know, I don't have many slimes. And then the way out, I mean, that's not going to go back into my house. Who wants people drudging like mud and, which one do I want? That's this key. Mud and rocks and stuff like that through my nice shiny house. So obviously this goes outside. Ugh. And you jump out here. Now this is my house. We've had a new patron join. He's currently waiting for the payment to go through on actual Patreon, but I was like, ah, why not? You can come over and start playing. This is Decipher's place down here, looking lovely. He literally was just on, but yeah, he got to go back to work. You know, he takes his little time out every now and then when he can, making a lovely little area around here, stained glass in effect everywhere. And he found this lovely lake to be next to, so which I think is amazing. The nether hub, such as it stands, is kind of coming along. Let's go in. There were vines here last time. Wow, things change all the time. I don't need to eat. We've basically chunked out. Hey, it's still super loud. Let's turn that down more. We've basically chunked out quite a large area here for stuff. I've turned it down too far. This one is the Cypher's area. Then over here we have Spawn, and Forest made his little portal over there. No one else really has started one as far as I'm aware. We've got a Blaze Spawner there, and some stuff over this way. Let's go and have a look. I don't have any fire resistance potions, but we should be all right. That's because I've not fought any blazes. I haven't got any blaze rods to make a potion stand. We could do that now? Do we want to do that now? I don't know. Let's go have a look. If I could face one not in a spawner, that would be great. I mean, I've only got 13 dirt to make protective battlements with. Everything's so well lit up, I don't think we're actually going to find anything spawn. Let me run around for a little bit and see what we can find. Okay, maybe not into fire, but we can get some achievements here. Not this one. Let's just see how long... Yep. There we go, try and fire them back. You've just got to keep trying. Hope that one of them just takes the nice random path back that you wanted to take. He's going away. He's running away from me. Come on, let's do this. He's not going to do it, is he? Running away. Okay, we're going to have to do this in the dodgy manner. Just try and milk a spawner here. This kind of looks quite a nice area, so let's see what we can do about making this a bit more attack friendly. Yeah, just like that. Now I'm spam hitting. That's no good. There we go. That's what we wanted. Any more? Did we get a thing? We did not get a thing. That is unfortunate. Okay, so let's take that off my bar and put this here so that we can very quickly... okay, I see a bit of a problem here. We got too many on the go. Why am I lagging like that? That is unbelievable. Okay, obviously some settings need to be tweaked on my PC because I shouldn't be struggling anywhere near that much. Hopefully we can do this without getting killed. I'm not sure if they're going to come at me at all. Would be nice. Okay, let's try and just... I don't know, maybe I need to turn my particles down for the moment. Not sure what's going on. Not sure what's going on with the lag. Have I just jumped straight onto fire? I did not. That's good. Okay. We should be able to just kind of tempt them out somehow. Oh man, this whatever this lag is, it's deadly. Deadly. Oh, it's all over. It's not over. Ooh. Okay, that was pretty good. But still, like, I've killed three of them now. Not a single blaze rod has been dropped, which is unfortunate. I'm not sure what I'm going to do about this. Yeah, I killed them right here. They managed to come down into a nice little kill zone. Maybe we can get him around here. Burnt myself again. That's okay, though. That's okay. Nothing that we can't really deal with. I took my torches off my bar. Oh, okay. How did they get hold of me like that? How? Ooh. How many do I have to kill? Alright, well, they've all got outside now, and everything's going super laggy, and I have no idea why, because I'm pulling 120 frames per second, so it all looks totally fine, but the jitters. Okay, well, we'll have to come back at some point and try that again. Maybe try that on the one over by the entrance. I feel a little like, ooh, we've got so much done that maybe I should carry on pushing through. I mean, I'm at full health. Nothing really bad has happened. Ooh, apart from, come on through. I heard one die. What? How did one die? How did that happen? Anybody know? Oh wow, craziness. Craziness. Did you see them all there? Did you see them all? I don't think I'm going to be able to take any of them out. Can they hurt each other? Is that even a thing? So I definitely heard another one die as I ran through. We're going to strafe sideways and see if we can see it. I'm not sure. I'm trying to find a blaze rod, as you guys know. There we go, got one. Oh my gosh, all that time. I just had to go in and fight one properly. Okay, that's it, I'm done. I'm out of here. Whoa. Okay, here we go, we're gonna try and get a return to sender. Oh, really? Come on, one of these should do it. That's carnage. We can do this though, we can do this. Just wait my time, get the right shots. Oh, that was not the right shot. Why can't I hit these balls? I'm normally pretty good at this. Not today, it turns out. Not today. Why not today? Alright, let's come down here. Let's see what's going on. Like, has fire become super laggy in 1.9 or something? there really is something terrible going on here. I know fire was never the best anyway. Why can't I get those? But, man, I used to handle it a lot better than this. A lot better than this. Okay, looking around, there's a guy. Well, the footage was getting so laggy, I decided it might be best to return to the overworld. And look, back to glorious 120 frames per second. I mean, like, what? I don't know. Things are going weird. Things are going weird. So I did it. I built the thing that I said I was going to build. I have got a kennel here. You can just about see them over there. We'll go in and have a look. I ended up moving this down just one block here to give like some sort of depth of layering thing, which is quite good. This is just kind of a rough draft of what I want here. Oh no, I have misplaced a block. That is unfortunate. I'll get up there and sort it out. As you can tell, by the way, there's no fences back there. I might even have some fences on me. I do. Let's go and see if we can finish off the build live on camera. Well, look at this, brilliant. Oh, we're one short. Oh well, that's probably why I went to go sort it out. But you get the general idea. The inside, it's quite nice. It's a rough little area. I haven't really finished the walls up here, unfortunately. I'm just not sure what to do. You can see how it's all on the half slab and stuff like that. I'm not sure whether I want to keep this either. It's a nice little addition for getting up and down up there. We have somewhere to keep all our rotten flesh here. I don't actually have anything on me, but kind of what I came in here for. I wonder what happened to it. I don't know. But then you can also get all these dogs out from here. Now, I did put these up on top here because I thought it would be more in keeping with the style of a dog cage, but that's just awkward. That's a lot easier to be able to get my dogs out, I think. So let's go along and quickly do this. Look, more on-camera building. Isn't it amazing? I know this episode has been pretty much all jump cuts, but the reason for that, well, is because we've been doing stuff, a lot of stuff. If you think about where we started with the great big open field, and now we've got the lightning strikes. Really gonna have to do something about that. But this whole server has moved on heaps and bounds. But what's this over here? I would like to say thank you to everyone that's been involved. Well, all my patrons in particular. These are the four Minecraft players that have signed up, and we also have one more. I'm gonna call him the non-crafter. Now let's see it, Robert. In fact, I'm going to go make sure that I'm going to get his spelling right. Ah, thank God for people that don't have awkward names. The non-crafter Robert Beardsley. I would like to say thank you to all your people. You have been supporting me, or particularly Misaligned and Robert Beardsley, for 3 months now. 3 months. And this is all I've been able to do to say thank you. So this and many more things will be coming. To everyone watching this video, I would like to say thank you very much for joining me for this adventure. We will see you next time, where I'm going to do more stuff with all these guys. Hopefully we'll be able to do stuff with all these guys when I make, I don't know, some sort of game or something somewhere. Oh, look, we can fix this. I will be working on the internals of my house in between this episode and whatever happens next. So we will start with a nice little tour around and some sort of idea of, I don't know, maybe a big group project that we can all do together. I'm thinking maybe ice boat races, maybe some sort of battle arena or something. We have the command blocks. We can do things. But anyway, until then, bye!